On December 17, 1903, two brothers from Dayton, Ohio, would alter human history forever. On that day, Wilbur and Orville Wright flew their wooden and canvas machine off the sandy dunes in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, becoming the first to flight. Heavy experimentations with gliders, like advancements in engine technologies, controls, and aerodynamics, provided a pathway for heavier-than-air crafts, like the Wright Brothers Flyer. By the 1930s, airships, which have dominated the long-distance flight, were replaced by flying boats and other rudimentary aircraft. By the 1930s and 40s, development of aircraft for war effort greatly accelerated the infusion of new technologies into civilian general aviation. This stream of innovation led to the start of the jet age, which would revolutionize both general and military aviation. Later in 20th century, even more advanced technologies like digital electronics would bring about fly-by-wire, digital engine controls, GPS, and these advancements even changed the way we go about designing aircraft. This century has been marked by transitioning to large-scale pilotless drones, and for the first time ever, inherently unstable aircraft, such as highly integrated flying wings, have become a possibility. And with all these advancements in the past 112 years, we're still only scratching the surface of capability and performance, but we're paying a heavy price for lagging innovation. Who here has traveled by air in the past 6 months? Were you surprised by the cost and time of your trip? Today, we find ourselves at the doorstep of yet another revolutionary advancement in aviation history, electric or hybrid electric aircrafts. NASA is investing in Electrified Aircraft Propulsion Research, or EAP, as part of its portfolio to improve fuel efficiency, emissions, and noise levels in commercial transport aircraft. EAP uses electric motors to drive some or all of the engines on an aircraft. The energy source for the system can be electric, hybrid, or turboelectric. NASA is working across a range of markets, from urban air mobility to subsonic transport. Each market has differences in vehicle size, range, and speeds. Our strategy at NASA is to work with our industry partners to enable technology development, demonstrate these technologies in flight, and transfer the knowledge to commercial sector for future products and markets. One such emerging market is urban air mobility, developed through NASA's revolutionary vertical lift technology project. Urban air mobility, or UAM, is a conceptual market that would enable passenger carrying air transportation in and around metropolitan areas. Think of flying Ubers. These vehicles could use all electric or hybrid electric propulsion systems capable of vertical takeoff and landing. The overarching goal of NASA's work in this space is to develop and validate tools, technologies, and concepts to overcome key challenges for vertical lift vehicles. A critical challenge for UAM market growth is public's acceptance that these vehicles can be as safe as commercial air travel or automotive transportation. However, the most immediate impact from NASA's work for the flying public is the reduction in cost through fuel burn improvements and lower airfare prices. To put that in context, let's look at some numbers. The overall global fleet of large commercial aircraft totaled over 25,000 in 2017 and is expected to grow to 37,000 aircraft by 2027. Out of the 25,000 aircraft today, nearly 60% of those are narrow-body aircraft, small regional aircraft, both jet and turboprops. Saving just 10% in fuel consumption across this fleet would yield more than 5 billion gallons of fuel savings per year and is forecasted to save approximately 10 billion gallons by 2040. We also have to take into account the reduction into CO2 emissions. So how do we get there? The leading concept that NASA is currently investigating for partially turboelectric configuration is single-aisle turboelectric with Ive-Bandrelaer propulsor known as Stark-Able. This configuration is being developed, assuming entry into service by 2035. It consists of two underwing turbofans with generators extracting power from turbofan shafts and transmitting it electrically to rear fuselage boundary layer ingesting fan. One of the main sources of drag on an aircraft is a layer of slow-moving air that builds up along the fuselage and wings, known as boundary layer. Boundary layer creates extra drag, and we believe we can improve aircraft performance by embedding engines into the airframe and having those engines consume boundary layer air. By ingesting boundary layer, the drag is significantly decreased, which leads to an overall improvement in aircraft efficiency. Results indicate that this turboelectric concept has an economic fuel burn reduction of 7%, an emission fuel burn reduction of 12% comparing to other aircraft designs. Several years ago, NASA has developed an advanced and highly integrated concept known as N3X, which explored fuel savings by combining a blended wing body design with fully turboelectric and fully distributed propulsion system based on superconducting electric machines and power distribution. The fuel benefits of this configuration is very significant, estimated at nearly 70% reduction comparing to conventional aircraft such as Boeing 777. This concept has the best benefits so far studied. However, it requires the most aggressive technology and infrastructure development. And last but not least, NASA is building its first ever all-electric X-plane, X-57 Maxwell. This design will demonstrate an effective interaction between a wing, the engine propellers, and the flight mission flight path, while simultaneously solving a number of challenging technical issues for electrified propulsion in crew-rated aircraft. While electric motors are more efficient than fuel-burning engines, they produce a significant amount of heat during operation, requiring an integrated thermal management system to be incorporated into the design. Now, a common method of solving such heat-related problems is to employ an embedded heat sink or a large metal heat sink or water cooling system. But this can cause a dramatic increase in weight, thus reducing the benefit gained by electric conversion. One such research effort to control the heat generated by these systems was performed late last year by my team, where we developed a 98% efficient 13 kilowatt power system for X-57 high lift propulsors, weighing only 2 pounds and completely air-cooled. This system was fully qualified across various facilities at NASA Glenn in 10 short months. And within the next 2 years, our system will be flying on X-57 flights, proving that it is possible to have a lightweight, air-cooled solution for aircrafts. In order to qualify the components in this electrified air and aviation, NASA needed to develop capability to test and verify them before in-flight testing. So we converted our hypersonic test facility in Plumbrook Station in Sandusky to NASA Electrified Aircraft Testbed, NEAT. Currently, this state-of-the-art facility is being used to test full-scale megawatt powertrains with an eye towards incorporating component technologies into an overall system. The facility can support single-aisle aircraft geometries with proper cable lengths and electromagnetic interference mitigation. It can supply power for up to 24 megawatts, thermal management system for up to 2 megawatts, and it even contains an altitude chamber that can simulate up to 120,000 feet. All electric aircraft concepts that we've seen so far rely heavily on advancements of components such as advanced motors, power converters, and material science, to name a few. X-57 work is an example of much larger research portfolio within the field of power systems led by NASA Glenn. Over the past 20 years, Glenn has pioneered designs of various high power, density, and high efficient motors for space, aeronautics, medical, and terrestrial applications. All our work has always pushed the boundaries of what's possible, and our newest motor work is no different. NASA Glenn has a small in-house team that is developing a 1.4 megawatt motor with a performance goal of 16 kilowatts per kilogram and efficiency greater than 98%. The motor contains a self-cooled superconducting rotor, which has never been done before, allowing the motor to achieve exceptional specific power and efficiencies without inheriting external cooling weight penalty, commonly attributed to superconducting machines. Integrated rotor superconductor, spinning at 6,800 RPM, four times higher than the state of the art, and weighing only 80 kilograms. This motor revolutionizes the field of advanced motors and greatly increased number of aircraft concepts that can utilize hybrid architectures. All our electric motor work is all diverse in size applications and power levels. And it's beyond the world of aeronautics. Just 5 years ago, my team designed, built, and delivered a biconical motor to University of Indiana School of Medicine. This motor was designed to help catalyze advancements in the field of cardiovascular assist devices, such as pacemakers for kids who are born with a single heart ventricle. This motor is tiny in comparison to the ones on the aircraft, just 2 inches tall, and is powered by a total of 5 watts, same power as USB ports on your computers. Currently, our design is being used to develop a clinical trial version, and hopefully a viable device will enter a market within a decade, saving an estimated 1,500 children per year. All great progress is accompanied with great difficulty and must be enterprised and overcome with answerable courage. In our efforts, we don't underestimate the power of vision and direction. These are irresistible forces able to transform what might appear to be unconquerable obstacles into traversable pathways and expanding opportunities. I am deeply humbled to have an opportunity to be part of this amazing journey, a journey that will surely change the world.